Okay, so this is the second video talking about how to get random gates using maths. In this case, we're just going to be using a noise source rather than the sample and hold that we did before. So same basic patches here. All I'm doing is listening to the final output of the DPO. And our goal here I already have in. We're going to be using the end of rise output from channel 1 of maths to trigger the strike input on channel 4. So to understand why maths is going to act the way it does in this patch, I'm going to briefly explain comparators. They're very important for maths and very important for synthesis in general, especially when it comes to oscillator circuits. So a comparator, this is the representation you would see on a circuit diagram. It takes two voltages in and sends one voltage out. The two input voltages can be whatever you want. You're going to have V1 and V2. V1 is your input signal. V2 is your reference signal. Your output voltage is going to be binary or digital or high or low. It can only be one of those two states. It's going to be high or low. The output will go high if the input voltage is higher than the reference voltage. If the input voltage is lower than the reference voltage, the output voltage is going to be low. What determines what the high voltage and the low voltage is the supply voltage, which is indicated here. So if the supply voltage is positive 5 volts and minus 5 volts, your high and low states will be plus 5 volts and negative 5 volts. If you just have a positive supply and this side goes to ground, you'll have a positive voltage and zero. So why does this matter? Let's think about a triangle oscillator. Most oscillators are going to be have a triangle core or a saw core, which means their fundamental wave that's being created is either a triangle wave or a saw wave. A really easy way to get the square wave output is to feed the oscillator through a comparator. Sometimes I say comparator even though I know that's wrong. Let's follow the zero crossings in the triangle wave here. So here we're above our reference voltage, which we're going to assume is 0 volts. Our reference voltage goes up, so we're in a high state. Here we're below 0 volts, so we're going to be in the low state. Here we're above, below, etc., etc. So right away, with just adding this one component, this one op amp, you can have the square wave output from your triangle wave oscillator. Works the same with a sawtooth oscillator. So let's see what happens when we change. We leave V1, or our input voltage, the same, but we change V2, our reference voltage. So now we're going to say that we've offset our reference voltage from 0 volts to this blue dotted line, which we'll say is 4 volts. So you can see only a small bit of the triangle wave pokes up above that threshold, that reference voltage. As such, the width of our pulse has been modified. Okay, so now this square wave, or this pulse wave, will have the same frequency as the input oscillator frequency, but the timbre will be different because the duty cycle on the pulses has changed. So now let's say that we don't have a fixed 4 volts, but we modulate this reference voltage. So we could put anything in, like a slow sine wave LFO. So now we're modulating this. So you can imagine that these pulses are going to go wider or narrower. So the pulse width is being modulated, and that's exactly what we have. So with just a comparator being fed your oscillator voltage, you can very easily get the square wave output from an oscillator, as well as pulse width modulation by varying the reference voltage. Which is great, and this is all background, but what does that have to do with maths? So now let's look at how this affects us in our patch. Remember I said we're going to be able to get random gates using maths only and a noise input. So we're going to assume this is going into channel 2. Now remember, maths will have a rise and fall that responds to either the slewed signal that it creates or the input signal. So you can see that maths will see a rise and a fall, and it will say end of cycle. Rise, fall, end of cycle. Rise, fall, end of cycle. Rise, fall, end of cycle. Now, because we're feeding in noise, this is all going to happen very quickly. Now, what would be nice is if with maths, we could change V2 in order to raise it up so that all we see, pretend that's a straight line, that all we would see are the little high values that would poke up above them. But with maths, we can't actually change the reference voltage when it's acting like comparator. But what we can do is change the input voltage, because remember, maths has the ability to create an offset, both positive and negative, on channels 2 and 3. So what happens if we combine this with a negative offset from channel 3? Now we can see that when we combine the negative offset voltage from channel 3, so we shift the whole signal down so that only the peaks will come up above 0. And when we have peaks above 0, the maths end of rise and end of cycle gates can be used. And with this, with maths acting as a comparator, we'll have random gates. In order to do this, we're going to be using 3 channels of maths. If that seems like a lot and it ties up your maths, well, then you probably should have a second maths. But what we're going to be doing is taking the noise input and sending it through the bus to get to the sum output. And then that's going to go back to channel 1. So first things first, we're going to take the pink noise output from my noise source. We're going into channel 2. Now, in order to adjust the amplitude of channel 2, you can just use the attenuverter here. It actually doesn't matter which way you go, but we're going to turn that up. Also, mind that the attenuverter for channel 1 is set to null. After that, we're going to patch the sum output back into the channel 1 input. And it sounds like we got noise. So the more you turn that up or down, you can see we've got noise because it's always seeing a signal and it's always going to be triggering. So now all that's left to do is to adjust the DC offset on channel 3. So you can hear as we turn it down what happens. So now we're hearing exactly what I described before, which is the little bits of random values that peak up above the threshold that are going to be sending us our random triggers. And if we want them to be further apart, we can keep lowering it down. If we want them faster, we just raise it up. And if we just want noise, we can turn it up. But there you go. With just a maths and a noise source, we've got randomly spaced gates. And hopefully the information on comparators and how they work was helpful too.